up, guys? I'm Steph Castellan, and I am super excited to have you here today. I wanted to do a quick video to show you the benefits of joining a blogging-specific Facebook group, because it's something that I recently joined, and I wish I had done it sooner. These Facebook groups are great because they can help your blog grow, they can answer any questions you might have, and mostly, it is a community of bloggers looking to help each other and cheer each other on. So let's take a closer look, and I'll show you guys more. Here we go. Blogging Facebook groups. Now you guys know, or you might not know, that I swear there is a Facebook group for everything. You can look for a Facebook group and it will be there, I promise. I had read about blogging Facebook groups before, but I didn't really know how they would benefit me or how they would fit in with my blogging journey, so I hesitated to join them for quite a while, but I recently did and I'm so glad that I found them because mostly, and my favorite part, is that they are just a big community of bloggers. There are people in there with lots of experience, many, many years, and a lot of success, and there are people who are just starting and don't even have their domain name yet. You're getting all different kinds of experience levels and people that you can relate to. You find other people sharing their fears and their doubts and their hesitations, and then also sharing and cheering each other on with their successes and big wins. It's also great that you can be as involved or not involved as you want to be. You can be a part of it daily and interact and engage and ask questions and provide answers, or you can just kind of stay on the side. So it can be whatever you want it to be, and I like that because it doesn't feel like another social media thing that I have to be a part of. So with these blogging groups, I have noticed five particular things and I wanted to share them with you. Number one, just like all the Facebook groups out there, there are a ton of blogging Facebook groups. So if you just go to the search bar and type in blogging groups, you're gonna get a whole bunch of different options. And typically for these ones, you have to answer some questions or verify that you read the guidelines. So they're not as simple as just joining and being a part of it. You actually have to be approved. So when I did this, because I wasn't approved right away, I requested to join like 15, and to me that's way too many. I found three that I really, really enjoy being a part of and would recommend, but you go ahead and do your own research and find out what's the best fit for you. The three groups that I like and particularly recommend are Blogging for New Bloggers, Blogging Babes, and Blogging Like We Mean It. I just find myself gravitating to them more than the others. So do your own research and find the ones that fit your style, knowing that you can always join more in the future or get out of the group if you want to. The second thing is to ask questions, respond, and engage. This is a group of people who have been there before. They've done the blogging thing. They've had the struggles and the trials and errors and the SEO and working on Pinterest and doing an email list. Like, they've done it all before. It's great to use as a resource to ask questions, but then also to answer questions. If you've written a blog post that can help someone, it's a great way to promote your work. You know, sometimes there's a question on there like, who out there is a travel blogger? I'm looking for ideas on gear reviews. And so you can link your blog post if you did a gear review. The one thing to be mindful of is that some people have affiliate links and they're out there to promote their own work, which is a good thing of promoting your work, but not when you do it in kind of a sleazy way. So like when I was going from Wix to WordPress, I asked for the best hosting platform to use, and someone actually wrote on there and said, hey, I don't have an affiliate link and you have to watch out because a lot of people are gonna respond that do have an affiliate link, but here's what I use and suggest. So be aware of that, but don't worry about it. So the third thing I noticed about these groups and really like is that you can search for a keyword throughout the discussion. So again, when I was switching my blog from Wix to WordPress, I just typed in Wix to that search bar and it showed me all of the posts and discussion that included the word Wix. So a lot of other people had a similar question to me and I could read the responses as well as ask my own question. This is great if you have a question about anything, Tailwind, emails, how to start your blog, what hosting platform to use, whatever it may be, instead of doing a Google search and getting so many different ways of doing it, you can go to a group that you're a part of and get it straight from the people who have done it before. Straight from the people who have experienced it, who are experiencing it, and can tell you what it's like in real life. So that, like, I love this because, like I said, the community is so helpful and they all seem to be so willing to share their experiences. And that search bar is such a good tool for any questions that you might have. The fourth thing that I've observed in these groups is that someone somewhere in these groups has gone through what you're going through before. In the blogging world, people create a lot of courses as a source of income, but what's great is that you can ask for reviews and recommendation on these courses. So if you want to dive into SEO, you could say, hey, has anyone taken this course on SEO? Or does anyone recommend the best SEO course out there? there and they're gonna give you their opinions. So where I am now with my blog, kind of having my foundation set and moving into some of those course-like avenues, it's really nice to have different opinions of different people who have tried these different courses. So that's something that's been really helpful with these Facebook groups. And the fifth thing, some of these groups have challenges. Now you can be a part of them or you don't have to, and I don't really know how I feel about them yet. I've definitely participated in them, but it kind of reminds me of the follow-unfollow game over on Instagram, which I am not a fan of and do not believe in at all. I guess it's a way to create engagement with your social media and blog. For example, they might say, post a link to your Facebook page and like 5 other Facebook pages that comment on this. So the idea is that you go like 5 other Facebook pages that commented on that thread, but then also you're going to get likes. So I don't know, it feels kind of cheap to me. You can totally see where I'm getting the follow-unfollow game. But I will say with the Pinterest challenges, it's gotten me some traction. You know, they say post a pin and repin 5 others. So this pin that I link gets shared by 10 other bloggers and then their audience sees it and it keeps going and going. I don't know that it's necessarily a long-term answer, but I do think that if you're just starting and need to get some traffic to your website or your social medias, that this is a really interesting but also feels more intentional way to do it. So I don't know, tomatoes, tomatoes, right? I've definitely participated in some, but I've backed off from them just knowing that I want to grow my audience a different way. So that's it. That is blogging Facebook groups in a nutshell, and I just wanted to share more with you guys because it's a great resource that I've recently found, and if it's helping me, it'll help you guys because it is my goal to help you guys. So definitely look into these no matter where you are on your blogging journey, whether you're just starting or haven't even started yet, or you're a few years in. I really think you'll enjoy these Facebook groups, and again, just the community. You really get people who cheer you on and share their experiences. A lot of it is successes and like big things happening, but then there's also the very real and the shortcomings and the failures and the fears, and there's so much inspiration and realness behind that too. That's the whole spectrum of the blogging journey. So what do you guys think? Are Facebook groups something you're doing, something you're going to do, something you're interested in, have no idea about, and now are like, whoa, I need to join Facebook groups? Let me know down below. Make sure you subscribe, hit that like button, and just thanks for being here today. I really appreciate it. I'll see you guys soon. Bye.